my name is Don Anderson, and I used to be in a band called Agalock, and then everybody quit on me.
Thank you.
from one of my very favorite albums or EPs that iBlock ever did. Pardon me while I tune. And sorry, here's the mic. And it's called the White EP. Is anyone familiar with the White EP?
Woo!
Coming back. It's being reissued by Eisenvolt. So it should be reissued with the gray, which no one likes, but. But so you can tolerate the gray. It's become like a double package, I think. So you tolerate the gray EP, but the white EP's on it. And I'm really happy with the white EP because technically we had an EP planned for 2004, and it was really didn't really come together the way we wanted it. There we go. And so we scrapped it. And it ended up kind of being scattered across our discography. Parts of it ended up in the Ashes vinyl version, like our focus recording part 4. A lot of it ended up on what became the White EP. And it's one of my favorite things we've done. So I'm going to play a tune from that once I get my A string up. It's the Weather. And I'm assuming you've all seen The Wicker Man. The Nicolas Cage version, yes. This song is inspired by not that version, but the Christopher Lee.
Same way.
to reverence the music and the drama and rituals of the old gods, to love nature and to fear it, and to rely on it and to appease it when necessary.
Brought me up.
He brought you up to be a pagan.
A heathen, conceivably, but not, I hope, an unenlightened.
This one we've never ever. Actually, we did play Swirl of Room once as a band. It was on the day that Christopher Lee passed away. And we were on our way to play a gig in Phoenix, Arizona. And you may not know this, but it was the same day that Ornette Coleman also passed away.
That's true.
And so, for a brief time, we thought, well, we should play Swirl of Room, but maybe we could do like a sort of spaz jazz version of it to sort of honor both Ornette Coleman and Christopher Lee simultaneously, but that was quickly vetoed. So we stuck with the original plan of just doing it the original way. So we've only played that once, but this next song is called Birch Black. We've never played it as a band. From the Mantle, and a little bit of a story behind it. You probably already know, if you're old musicians, that so many songs are written in the key of E and A because. And we got really tired of that, so John one day decided to close his eyes, fall back on his bed, and just grab any chord he just happened to instinctively grab. And he instinctively grabbed this one. And all of a sudden, he just wrote a song in G sharp minor. He had no idea the whole time. But this song is called Old Doll, and it's a very important song to all of us. We wrote it thinking a lot about our time growing up in the Northwest, and living in Portland before Portlandia, and before all this sort of thing. And in many ways, the Mantle was our sort of love letter to Portland, Oregon, one that's long since passed and has been completely taken over by condos. So, this is Old Doll.
Thank you.
Balaam and Freya and Black Hawk Avalon for hosting Lithia and inviting me to play. It's really an honor and a joy to be here with all of you, playing this with the birds singing along and being out in nature, which is, this is very much where I grew up, and it means a lot to be able to play some Agalloch songs here. The next song is a song we're still playing live, but, and I would like to dedicate it to someone who was very upset when we couldn't agree on playing live, and one of the band members of Agalloch, Aesop Decker, over there. Jason's coming later, but these are two of my very best friends, and John Hamm is also one of my best friends, and we've long since reconciled and have become friends again. And when I told them that I was playing on Like the Waves, I said, well, you never wanted to play it live. It always really mighty live, you only come across right. So this song is not Like the Waves, and I'd like to dedicate it to John Hamm, who I'm happy to call a friend again.
Thank you.
has a bit of a story because I originally wrote this next song for Sculptured. And I didn't have room on it on the last Sculptured record. And so when we started to do Marrow of the Spirit, I said to John, I said, I have this really, really nice song that might work with Agalloch. But unfortunately, the title of the song is Help, I Swallowed My Teeth. And I was really obsessed with like body horror and this sort of stuff, and I had terrible orthodontic history. So I used to have nightmares of swallowing sharp objects. So I was always have nightmares of swallowing my teeth. So I said, but that's not very Agallochian, is it? So I said, okay, you take the song, you write lyrics, you come with a title. And it's the song that closes Marrow of the Spirit. It's called To Drown. Thank you. I play is, it's a very, very, very obscure one. And I got the title for this while watching Twin Peaks Fire Walk With Me.
Oh.
And since we're somewhere near Twin Peaks in a way. And I believe it was Jacques Renaud, I'm not sure which character, but they were in a saloon and he said the phrase, "Tomorrow will never come." And I thought that's a great song for that, so I said it had nothing to do with the subject matter of the song. And then I was taking a class on schizophrenia, and I heard a video of a young man who was suffering schizophrenia, and it moved me. He was talking with his father, and I was just really just deeply moved by it, and I wanted to use it for the song, and so that's where that sample comes from. The song is for Gerald.
See, I still have this male aggression thing, and I don't know if you're going to kill me. Enough's enough. Because we were getting 20 gunshots tonight, and I couldn't figure out where they were coming from. I went out there and found out. Everybody was shooting everybody. There was a lot of stress in that city. It's in Detroit, as far as stopping the crime, John Nichols, because he knew what he was doing. Danny, you know how you feel? I feel the worst thing. That man, if I wanted him to, have said, get out of the government, leave me alone, wouldn't do it. He is a father complex. He's not a wishy-washy father complex. He's 68 years old, and he still kicked my ass. You know, I can boot squat, boot bad. I don't have any phone at all. The police department was phone. Yeah, there ain't no fun out there killing people, no. I've got a certain amount of common sense to precedent and morals and whether you believe it or not, you taught me a lot. Somewhere you lost your love capacity. Are you okay? I'm scared of you. Who do I go to? Thank you.
song. And I'd like to thank each and every one of you for coming and listening to me play these songs. They're songs I still love to play. And this next one is a very, very important song to me. And I'd like to dedicate it to the memory of my father.